Hello everyone, this is Bitcoin Sofia, and in this video I'm going to explain why I'm so freaking annoyed with this recent Bitcoin bug. Okay, so what happened was that Bitcoin Core team released a statement that they're fixing the denial of service bug, which turned out to be more than a denial of service attack. Yeah. Okay, then it turned out that this bug was disclosed by Bitcoin Unlimited developer. Bitcoin Unlimited is a node that runs on Bitcoin Cash. And that has nothing to do with it. Why am I annoyed? I'm annoyed for two reasons. First is everybody seems to think that this is not an exploitable bug. Everybody seems to say, oh, but people wouldn't have done that because the only people who could do that are miners, and miners wouldn't destroy their investment because of game theory. And game theory only works if you actually measure the numbers. And I can tell you the numbers now. It doesn't work. They totally would do the attack. Then you have the other problem, which is the whole disclosure thing. You see, when a bug is disclosed, and that bug involves multiple chains, then some secrecy is expected. There is a reason for that. Let me explain. So, once you have a fix to a bug, it is important. If the bug is exploitable and critical, and this bug is critical, it is important to connect to all sites, to all important websites, all important miners, and tell them to update first. Exchanges as well. Exchanges, miners, services, everything big. Because they are vulnerable. Especially the miners, they're really important to update. So, once that happens, once all pools are updated, then, and only then, can the bug be made public. And that, I don't know if that's what happened on Bitcoin Core. I cannot tell you if that's what happened. Because, obviously, that communication is secret. That's by definition. I assume that they were responsible and told all exchanges and told all other miners that they should update before they disclosed the actual information, the actual bug. However, that's not enough, because they're not the only chain that exists. They're not the only chain that uses this code. They actually need to keep it secret until all others fix their problems as well. And that didn't happen. That did not happen. Now, some Bitcoin Core guys will say, no, we're the only chain that matters. The others should fuck off. But it's the others that told you. It's the others that disclosed to you. And you couldn't wait. So that's about the disclosure. Now, how critical is this bug actually? I'm going to talk with numbers, and I'm going to talk with numbers for Bitcoin Core, for the BTC version. Why? Because it has the biggest numbers. It's the hardest one to attack. And even so, it's easy. Okay, let's go. First, how many blocks do you need? One. You need one single block to do the attack. When do you need that block? Well, if you discovered the bug before anybody else, you are not in a hurry. You don't need it today, you don't need it tomorrow, you need it eventually. So you need to make one attacking block, and you need to double spend in that block. Obviously, since you're making the block, you can customize that block, you can make it entirely filled with your transactions, all of which do a double spend. Okay, so what do you do after that block? You use bots, you use automation And that automation, immediately after the bot finishes adding the block, that automation starts spending, starts sending to exchanges, starts sending here and there and here. And that can even happen in your own block. Yes, people will notice. Yes, people will revert the chain. But that will take a few hours. In a few hours, you'll be able to withdraw so much Monero that you can retire. You can never... You don't need to ever work again. Let me explain. First, how much Bitcoin can be double spent this way? How much Bitcoin can you create out of thin air? Let's say that you have one single Bitcoin. One single. With the first transaction, just the first transaction in a block, and the block can contain several hundred transactions, you can make one into three. With the second one, you can make 3 into 9. With the third transaction, you can make 9 into 21, into 27. Do you get what I'm getting at? This increases exponentially. By the 200th transaction, you have so much Bitcoin that you won't be able to spend it ever. And you have enough transactions left to distribute it to all the exchanges in the world. You will be able to withdraw everything from them if they're properly automated. Everything that is at least in their hot wallets. You won't be able to attack the cold wallets. You need an actual person to do an action there. But you'll be able to completely withdraw everything from every hot wallet on every exchange. One single block can create more bitcoins than there are bitcoins existing right now. More, literally you can double the supply limit of Bitcoin. You can triple it. Why not? It's that easy. It's that big. So, some people say, yeah, but once you do that, your machines, your ASICs will become useless. Well, how many ASICs do you need? You need 400 ASICs. Not 4,000, not 4 million, 400. 400, currently, is enough to cover 0.01% of the hash power. Which means that in 2 months, you're likely to mine a block. Around 2 months, not exactly. Yeah, that's good enough. If you're an attacker, you don't need the block right now. You need it eventually. So you just start mining, give electricity for 2 months, and then, big deal, whoop-de-doo. 400 miners are useless now. So what? Every exchange there is will be completely dried up. Completely empty. At least their hot wallets. Especially the ones that are quick. Especially the ones like... Shapeshift, that was the name. That one will be completely dried up. Any similar exchange that does quick swaps, any exchange that can be automated will be abused by automated bots. That's what's gonna happen. And that's why this bug was critical. Game theory does not protect you, because game theory applies to big miners who are invested long term. 400 ASICs is not that much of an investment when you're stealing millions of bitcoins. So stop with the bullshit. Now, if you are one of these Bitcoin Core guys, not part of the team, but people who praise the Core team, just say thank you, Bitcoin Unlimited, for telling us about this bug. Because they did. They did tell Core about this bug. And I really hate the way Core discussed the bug publicly. The way Core explained to the whole world, hey, there is a bug. Everybody who uses our code is vulnerable. Some of the nodes had to update midnight, had to wake up, and update as quickly as possible because they were already being exploitable. They had to do it as quickly as possible. They had to patch immediately. This is not professional. This is not what good teams do. Okay, thank you for listening, and I hope you're more careful next time. Bye-bye.